Hello, everyone, and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube. Welcome back to my Vikings franchise, year two, the last season in Minnesota. Okay, the last three videos covered the offseason and the preseason, but now it's time to get down for real. Somebody forgot to pay the Metrodome lighting bill, at least on the outside of the stadium. Good thing they're moving to LA at the end of the season. But inside, the lights are on, and the fans are looking to see the 2012 version of the Minnesota Vikings. It'll be a nostalgic year as they close out their run in Minnesota. It's a very sad time. As you see, Tom Coughlin taking the sideline for the Vikings for the very first time as head coach. What a steal that was away from the Giants. So here we go. Vikings and Lions will open up week one. It's a divisional matchup to start off the season. But anyway, like I said, yep, lots of emotions running here, starting with this game right here in front of the home crowd. Only eight games left, presuming that they don't make the playoffs. If they make the playoffs, then maybe more. Matthew Stafford in to take over the Lions offense. You see his numbers from the last season. Pretty respectable. And so he drops back on the shotgun, throwing short there, and there's a big hit. That's Quentin Jammer getting his first action here as a Viking. And speaking of first action as a Viking, the blitz is on by the linebacker, and Connor Caruso, the number one draft pick, gets the sack of Stafford there, his very first NFL sack. Way to go, Connor Caruso. This pass had Megatron open, but it's overthrown. The Lions will have to punt. And Christian Ponder hits the field for the first time this season. Needs to improve upon that TD to interception ratio from last year. Had more picks than touchdowns. That's got to change if they're going to be successful. Speaking of changes, there are a few on the offense. You see Ernest Graham, Shalon Wells, and Isaiah Griffin featured there. Wells and Griffin, both rookies. There's Shalon Wells' first catch, the tight end rookie. Makes the first reception of his NFL career for 7 yards. Third and one now. A man who is well-versed in NFL play, Adrian Peterson, gets a first down. He's going to get the handoff to the left-hand side, get nothing on that play, maybe one. Now on second and nine, Ponder rolling to the right, not so fast. He's going to be dragged down for the sack. Third and 19 now, they need quite a bit of yardage. He's going to go underneath to Robert Meacham, the free agent acquisition over the offseason, but it's not enough for a first down. Back to the Lions offense, and Javid Best runs up a large hole there for a first down. He's going to bounce outside here. Poor tackling at the line of scrimmage gets him another 8 yards there. And then second and two now. Stafford going to throw, taking a chance. And that's a nice play by Jammer, getting right in there on Pettigrew and knocking that ball away. Very nice defense. Third and two now. What can they dial up here? Looking like a blitz up the middle, and they're going to get Stafford. That is Kevin Williams that gets him. He had a bunch of sacks last year. Game close to the record. Didn't quite get there. You see Percy making a tough catch here when they get back on offense. Hand off to AP up the middle. 5 yards. So second and five. Ponder pitches right to Peterson. There you go. He's got first down yardage. Cuts up for a little bit more. First and 10 now as the second quarter starts. Ponder has time to throw. He finds Shalon Wells, his rookie tight end. Another catch and a first down. Handing off to AP to the left-hand side. That one's a good for about 4 yards. The drive does stall out, and they kick quite a long field goal. It is good on fourth and seven. So 3-0 Vikings crack the scoreboard first. Stafford to work. Short to Calvin Johnson. Megatron breaks a tackle from Ben Lieber, and he is gone. The whole gang on defense cannot chase him down. Broken arm tackle by Lieber early in this play, as you see, and he's off to the races. That is your cover boy for Madden 13, Calvin Johnson. And he's torching the Vikings defense right there. Just like that, the Lions have the lead, 7-3. So a lot of time left in the second quarter. Christian Ponder throwing over the middle to Wells. Once again, very short yardage, about 6 yards. But it's positive forward yardage. Peterson only gets about two here, so we've got a third and two play. Sue makes the tackle. So Ponder doing a little bit of adjustment at the line here to what the run call is. Hand off to AP. Look at the block by the fullback ahead. And Peterson has sprung free. He is gone. Long touchdown run for AP. His first touchdown on the season. Vikings reclaim the lead 10-7. Just like that with one swift run. Ernest Graham gets in front there at the fullback position. He was brought in as a free agent close to the start of the regular season. and he does not disappoint there. He gets a great lead block, springing AP for the long touchdown. Here's a big run by Javid Best for first down. Third and seven now with Stafford in the shotgun. Going to throw to the right side. It's Calvin Johnson once again. Big first down. Move the chains. He's already over 100 yards with that big touchdown catch. Hand off to Javid Best. Nope, doesn't fool him this time on the right-hand side. And it's a holding call that'll move the Lions back. That's costly because now it is second and 20. And they've moved back out of field goal range. But look at Young make this catch. Spin around Quentin Jammer. Oh boy, rookie mistake by Jammer letting him get to the sideline. And down first and goal. And on first and goal, Stafford calls his own number here and marches into the end zone. The Lions in this seesaw battle in the second quarter retake the lead again, 14-10. So it's back and forth, back and forth. What's the next chess move in this game? Well, Christian Ponder hoping it's a Vikings touchdown. We'll have to see. This pass is to Meacham, and it's dropped. It wasn't traffic, but Meacham's got to hold on to that. And it's third and 10 now. So where does Ponder go? He looks for Legadou Nene, who stretches out and gets the feet in bounds. What do they rule on the field? They say catch. Yes, very nice catch. Jim Schwartz doesn't think so. He's going to challenge, and we'll see what we get. So looking at the replay, Nene, it's the first time his name's been called today. He looks like he got both feet in bounds, and the official call, after they look at it in the replay booth, is upheld. There you go. The ruling's upheld. Good catch for the Vikings. Okay, now second and eight. Ponder to throw to AP. He's going to drag defenders over what he needs for first down yardage. First and 10. Look out, Ponder. Here comes a blitz. Nope. He had a man in the flat, but he wasn't quick enough. The blitz gets him for a 10-yard loss. Eventually punt this ball, and we're under a minute left in the half. Stafford going to wind up and throw deep. Uh-oh. That is Smith wide open. He burnt Quentin Jammer for the touchdown. How do you let someone get behind you with less than a minute to play in the half? But Jammer, well, kind of showing signs of his age there. We got him because of his experience, but there's going to be some downside to him as well, and I think you saw it exploited right there. So 21-10, only 40 seconds left. Look at this, Isaiah Griffin, the rookie, burns his man right off the line of scrimmage. Long touchdown catch for Isaiah Griffin, his very first in the National Football League. Ponder does exactly what Stafford did on the other side. He comes back and answers with a long touchdown pass. Coughlin's liking that. You have to ask the same question of the Detroit defense. What are you doing letting a guy burn you deep with that little time left in the half? So both teams trade touchdowns, and instead of a 21-10 deficit going into halftime, it's now cut 21-17. Very nice job, Isaiah Griffin. Rookie standing up big time here on that play and makes a name for himself in Minnesota right off the bat. So Coughlin has some work to do as they will trail going into halftime. He's got to make some adjustments on that defensive side if they want to stay in this game. But for now, it's a 21-17 game. So opening kickoff of the second half, Percy Harvin settling under to take this. He can be explosive, electric, but he's stopped at the 14-yard line. And even worse, he's hurt on the play. I don't think it's major, but it's something to watch. So third and eight, Ponder looking to throw. Nice little curl route by Meacham, but again, he's got the drops. Oh, Meacham, come on, you got to hang on to these catches. They're potential first downs. Instead, it's back to the Lions, throwing to Young. And again, they're not going to tackle him correctly at the sideline. Allow him to slip away, and he gets first down yardage. So this drive is headed towards the Vikings' end. Here you go. Pettigrew is hit hard, and Jard loses the ball once again. Javid Best going to get this draw call and get just enough for a first down. Look at him move the chains again. Third and 13. What can Stafford do here? Kevin Williams in his face. He's going to throw this out of bounds. No go there. It's fourth and 13. On comes the kicking team. And for once in a long, long time, it's not Jason Hansen out there. But it is good. So field goal by the Lions makes it a touchdown score. 24-17. And a handoff to AP right up the middle, ripping off yards once again for a first down. Gotta love that. He's got 119 on his own today. Second and 13. Wells gets open. I believe that's his fourth catch on the day. Shalon Wells showing up as a rookie. All our rookies are contributing on both sides of the ball here very nicely. Oh, this is dangerous. You remember how much time AP lost last year to injury? He's hurt again. He's holding his leg. We're saying meniscus tear, and he's out of the game. I just am fearful of how much longer it will be past this game. Ponder to throw. Isaiah Griffin open again First down yardage, 3rd and 24, they convert. He's got 107 yards on just the two catches. Electric. Toby Gerhardt is the replacement for AP. He's trucking forward. Look at that. No, you're not going to strip the ball. He's securing that. 1st and 10. Let's give it to Gerhardt again. Wide open down the middle there. Great blocking. And he's got 31 yards on just those two rushes. 1st and goal. Can the Vikings pound this in? Nice time to call play action here. And he goes to Kyle Rudolph, his sophomore tight end. Oh, he's to the goal line, but not in. They stand him up right at the goal line. Hand off to Toby Gerhardt, and he's in for the touchdown. Pay dirt for Gerhardt, who's come in here in spell of the injured Adrian Peterson. And tying up the ball game at 24. What a nice game here as the third quarter nears its end. What does Stafford have next? Well, a handoff to Jahvid Best that's going to get more yardage right up the middle. It should be noted again, as it was in the offseason videos, that the Vikings have decided to switch to a 3-4 defense here because of their strength at the linebacker position now relative to their D tackles. So they're trying out the 3-4 defense. Hopefully it'll work. There's a pass that's going to get them first down, and Jahvid Best racking up big yardage on that play. He's over 100 yards on the day on 17 carries. Lions are going for a go-ahead score. Jahvid Best leaves his feet. Taylor Mays meets him in midair. What a collision there. Stafford to the end zone. Touchdown. No, it's broken up the last second there, forcing a field goal try. So the Lions do get the lead, but not the touchdown they were searching for. 27-24. And a lot of time left. 7 minutes, 30 seconds. Ponder, nice protection. Going to hit Kyle Rudolph for short yardage. Gets him a good 6 yards. Good positive first down yardage. Allows you to do this. Hand off. Gerhardt, nice blocking up the middle. The brand new center makes a block. And Gerhardt is gone to pay dirt. Look at this big run. Was that AP? No. Gerhardt showing off the skills. Running right up the middle for a long touchdown. And that was Ray, the rookie center that had a part in that block up front, getting this. Oh, you see Ray there getting his block, moving up to the second level even, and getting a chip on a linebacker, freeing Gerhardt to go for the long touchdown score. Vikings in the lead, 31-27, but still a lot of time left. Toby Gerhardt's over 100 yards rushing. What is going on in this game? Okay, 5.5 minutes left. Stafford to Pettigrew. Nice catch, first down yardage, but uh-oh, Pettigrew is shaken up and injured. He's going to have to come off the field. 2nd and 11. Stafford throwing to Scheffler short. And that's another rookie, Jabbar Norton, coming up big on a tackle. Here you go. 3rd and 5. You've got a pass to the right-hand side. It's Scheffler again. He shuffles the feet. They say catch. Oh, man. 3rd and 5. We really needed to get that stop. Coughlin's not so sure he had both feet and down in bounds. So he's going to throw the challenge flag. He's his first challenge of the game. Those three timeouts are very valuable at this point of the game, but so is a chance to overrule this call. So you see Scheffler, a couple looks at this. I think the toe might have dragged on the white, but we will see what the call is. They look at this very carefully because we're right down to crunch time here. You see both coaches awaiting the answer, and the call is that this is actually overturned. A great call by Coughlin to challenge it, and they get the ball back on the punt. Oh boy, what a big turn of events. Ponder gets drilled, but not before he gets to Percy Harvin, who is back in the game after being shaken up. Gerhardt going to run forward and kill some time, get 3 yards, 2nd and 7. Ponder, quick drop, throwing to Percy Harvin. He makes a man miss, and he gets great yardage down into Detroit territory. That's what you want to see, but this does stall out. A punt attempt here now. Oh, keep it out of the end zone. Keep it out of the end zone. Yes, Griffin downs it at the 2-yard line, and that's a very tough situation for Detroit and their offense. 2nd down and 10 at the 2. Stafford heaving this one-on-one down the sideline. Nope, Taylor Mays knocks that down. Nice coverage, and it's 3rd and 10. The rush coming up the middle. He gets this ball off. He has a step. Nope, underthrown. Jabbar Norton, the linebacker, keeping up and tipping that away. 4th down and 10. They need this, or it's game. Stafford doesn't even give his wideout Calvin Johnson a chance to go up and get this. He throws it out of bounds. That's something you do cautiously in the first half, not when you need a 4th down conversion. So from there, Gerhardt from the 2-yard line plunges in for another score. That's his 3rd touchdown of the game, folks, spelling AP. Remember, AP went over 100 yards and had a touchdown himself. So 4th and 6, Stafford Well, this is just a formality now. They're down 11, but this ball is tipped, and Dickens makes the catch on the rebound, a crazy catch, but that is over. Tom Coughlin gets his first victory as a Viking head coach in his first attempt, and Toby Gerhardt is your player of the game. Well-deserved. Everyone pitching in to get the win in this seesaw game. You see a lot of yardage on both sides. This is a great game. 38-27 the final. Lots of stats going on. The Lions actually dominated a lot of the stats. They were ahead and let them ponder. 14 for 22, 252 yards, and a touchdown. 63% completion percentage, which is up from 50% last year. Stafford, 15 of 36, 356 and 2. He's a stud. That's a good game. Job at best, over 100 yards with 126. Stafford, the one touchdown run for 3 yards. AP, look at this, 116. Gerhardt, 113. 4 touchdowns out of your running backs. I'm a little afraid to find out where AP is in the injury. Shalon Wells, great first game. Isaiah Griffin, outstanding first game in the league. Everyone else chipping in and their respective positions there at the wideouts. For the Lions, Calvin Johnson was the stud once again, of course, but he had help. You see, Young had a great game. Dickens makes the one big catch for 55. Smith had the long touchdown as well. Jabbar Norton, the rookie out of Missouri State, dominates on the defensive side. 9 total tackles. What a job there in his first action in the NFL as well. Connor Caruso in the middle too. So look at AP, the meniscus tear. We catch a break and it's only 2 weeks. But those of you who told me to take Bob Sanders and said he'd be more reliable than he is in real life, right at you, folks. Bob Sanders, torn tricep, didn't even see him on the field, had to have been early, out for the season. He's as fragile as he is in real life. Okay, well, that's going to do it for this episode. Come on back next time when we travel to Jacksonville to play the Jaguars. See you then. Peace.